here at though. You're supposed to meet here at 9.
Hey,
what up, Ben?
Man, you ready?
Let's go, bro.
Ready to go fishing?
Let's do it, man.
So how you been?
What up, Ben? Let's do this.
You good? So is John here to give us our fishing lesson or not yet?
Dude, he just called me a minute ago and said that he canceled on it, bro.
Really?
Yeah, I'm like, man, it's about to be a good day for fishing, man.
Yeah.
Man, look at this. It's so beautiful today.
Hope we catch a lot of fish.
Heck yeah. What the heck? No fishing because of dead zones.
What's that?
I don't even know, bro. Like, I guess we can't go fishing.
I was really looking forward to it.
Oh, me too. Dang.
You guys want to know what dead zones are? I'll tell you what dead zones are.
According to the National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration, dead zones refer to a reduced level of oxygen in the water. Less oxygen dissolved in the water is often referred to as a dead zone because most marine life either dies or, if they are mobile, such as fish, leave the area. Habitats that would normally be teeming with life become essentially biological deserts. Hypoxic zones can occur naturally, but scientists are concerned about the areas created or enhanced by human activity. There are many physical, chemical, and biological factors that combine to create dead zones. Nutrient pollution is the primary cause of those zones created by humans. Excess nutrients that run off land or are piped as wastewater into rivers and coasts can stimulate an overgrowth of algae, which then sinks and decomposes in the water. The decomposition process consumes oxygen and depletes the supply available to healthy marine life.
Man, that guy didn't know what he was talking about. Dead zone. Like, that ain't gonna stop me from fishing.
Yup.
Man, that's big, bro. Like, you came out here, it's a beautiful day. Oh my god. Oh shoot, I got a fish. Oh shoot. Help me out, bro.
Bring it in.
You're
by the heat.
Look at all this fish we got, bro.
Oh yeah.
Fish sandwiches tonight.
Hey, did I tell you guys about dead zones?
Who are you, bro? Fake ass Bill Nye the Science Guy?
Just fishing.
Overfishing can cause dead zones. One example of this is the Bay of Bengal, where near Myanmar, 43% of the population is dependent on fisheries, thus causing much death.
You see that girl over there? She's cute.
The one in the pink?
Yeah.
She looks like a bomb. Like, yeah, I bet you won't get a number on this stuff. Hey, just throw that water bottle away for a second.
Just
toss that shit in the ocean.
Hey, don't you know littering's bad for the ocean?
You again.
Pollution is a large contributor that causes dead zones as well. Many of the underwater inhabitants that die due to dead zones and pollution also provide us with fresh and healthy food sources. More pollution goes out into the air and changes its quality for the worse. Because the ocean can't break down much of the trash material, the water is polluted. Animals choke on unfamiliar material, and because the water is poison, it kills various marine animals.
God, the ocean is just so beautiful now.
Like, yeah, it is.
The guy put things into perspective for me, man.
Well, what can we do to prevent dead zones?
We as people can do various things to help the ocean and help avoid dead zones, such as beach cleanups, pay better attention to what goes into our sewers, not pollute so much, and raise awareness towards dead zones.
You ready to head out?
I'm ready to head out, man.
All right, cool.
Look at them over there. They're littering.
They're littering.
Oh, let's get them.
Let's go.
We got this, bro.